Hello, everybody, all over the world. Welcome to a not angry stream. It's not like we've stopped streaming on Twitch or anything because their servers suck. Which is exactly what we're doing because their servers suck. And welcome, from now on, all streams are going to be on YouTube until further notice because I'm kind of fed up with stream not working, and I've tried YouTube twice, and both times have been super great. No problem whatsoever. So yeah, with that out of the way, let's go in and check out today's episode. It's going to be the Tomislav. A lot of you have already been looking at this slide for a while. And in case you're wondering about the quacks, it's because I bound my alt key. So whenever I alt tab, it's alt and tab. So when I alt tab, you get a quack. So that's why we know I'm here, right? It's kind of funny. Anyway, we're going to look at the Tomislav. It's a weapon that got changed in the gunmetal, and now it's actually really viable. I would say it's on par with the minigun. It's about as useful if you play with it in the style it is intended. And that's what we're going to examine today. So let's look at the stats here. Like all unlocks, it's based upon the stock. So this is compared to the minigun. So it's spins up 20% faster. It's 20% more accurate. It's silent when it's spun up, and it shoots faster. So spin up is faster. See, you can also do, like, if you jump and tap, you can, like, do this jump and maintain the speed. And you can shoot. And this kind of sounds like a dinghy, doesn't it? I mean, watch. Got that. Okay. Wait. Hold on. I swear to God, this is funny. Hold on. All right, close your eyes. Don't look. Okay, now you can open your eyes again. There comes the dinghy. Get on the boat. Oh, here comes another. I've done that joke 3 times today. Anyway, what I wanted to showcase here, the reason I have a bot here is just to demonstrate lively. I haven't done this before either, but there's a command you can do, which is bot mimic one, and then you have to change the offset to 0 so he faces the same way you do. So let's just both go in. That's it. We're gonna stop the mimic there. Wait, hold on. Stop following me. Stop. All right. So it goes, we're kind of... All right, so I guess this is good. So now we're gonna aim in the middle and we're just gonna shoot. And then we're gonna go a bit further back, go to the left, shoot here. And about here, I guess. Alright, thank you, bot number 2. So here we have. You can see that up close. Not the biggest difference. Mid range, however, is probably the most noticeable one, and long range is kind of like. This one is slightly better, but you can see, like, this weapon is clearly better at mid range around, like this distance here, I guess. It doesn't do more damage, but it's more accurate, so it's kind of like a hidden damage boost, I guess, in a way that you're more accurate. Like, you hit more of your shots, but you shoot slower, if that makes any sense. So the damage output is lower, but you sometimes hit for more. But that makes it all right, because you can actually be stealthy with this thing as a heavy, or you can do with ambush. So we're gonna examine why it's good. So let's go into the first replay here, and it's gonna be the Panic Police. He's going to be playing heavy here with the Tomislav. Of course, everyone's going to be playing with the Tomislav. First, he's going to be typing something on Facebook and be like, BRB, getting replays for HiGPS show that I'm going to be on just a minute here. And his friend's like, okay. And he also had, like, a date with, like, this really hot girl. And she was like, all right, dude, I totally understand. Like, postpone tomorrow. And it just made him, like, insanely more hot to her, I guess. So, on the roof here, it's still good against pyros, as you can see. And Still bad against chasing scouts because you still maintain the same speed. This seems a little bit quick, so let's turn it down just a little bit here. And, oh, another heavy here. Keep in mind, you will lose heavy fights most of the time. If you're not spun up, you will win. If you spun up and you are, you will lose. And the same way, too. It depends on the distance, too. It really depends on the individual heavy aim. And there we go. I think we kill the same pyro again. And it's TF2's birthday today, I believe. So he's using the panic attack because he's like, well, might use a good weapon and a shit weapon and mittens, which is kind of like a hit-and-miss kind of weapon. So, maintaining high ground, always good. Standard basic, giving up the high ground for no reason. Oh, the other heavy didn't hear him because he has silent spin-up time. Yes. And overextending a little bit, but nice to fall back. It's always good to do that. As a heavy, you don't really want to stay alone for too long, but you have no medic, so you have to rely on health packs, and this guy does not have any sandwich or the Lucas bar to heal himself, so he has to use health packs. That's a soldier with a stupid hat. So, standing on the roof here. Once again, didn't hear him, so he really didn't give off a lot of sound. However, he did when he shot, but I guess the constant sound of a spinning heavy is more of a giveaway than just some shots here and there. So, kind of just hiding here. This is also good because, you know, you don't hear them, but if you're just gonna, you know, first you're gonna stay and just stay spun up and then you're just gonna go and attack them anyway, you might as well be using the regular minigun because there's no point in, like, waiting for someone to come and attack you, and when they don't come because they're slow, you then go and attack. It kind of, like, beats the purpose. And then, oh yeah, look, panic attack. Entire episode, still shit. But yeah, that was kind of like the introduction to that, so let's see what happens if you shoot with this thing a lot. Like, you shoot a lot, because this weapon was before, like, the more you shoot with it, the less you the more you kind of wish you'd used the regular minigun, and this is kind of true to this one as well. Like, after a certain point of just shooting, you might want to have switched to something else. So this is going to be the Panic Police once again, and we are now on upward. Here, he's playing heavy. Kill this guy, and he's gonna explode into confetti because it's birthdays and some crap like that. Oh, an Uber! Alright, let's go. And okay, standing in front, and now we're gonna shoot a lot. Shoot. Get another heavy and keep shooting. At this point, we should really have been running the minigun, but hey, it doesn't matter. We got some kills, and it might not have made that much of a difference after all. See here, you can sneak around. Okay, going around, and like here would be a really good spot to just try and melee with the Killing Us boxing, because you might get those crits, you know. If you're like Killing Us boxing, we're gonna see that later. Actually, works really good with this thing if you just utilize the ambushing capabilities to boost your ability. And also, Demo Knights come and they're bullshit, and I kill you. But yeah, that's what happens when you shoot a lot. A lot of stuff dies. It's not as bad as that as it used to be. So, no episode is complete without playing Dust Bowl for some reason. And this is gonna be our Korean friend, Joinee Casey, from Taehyeonmingguk, which is Korean for Korea. And he's gonna be playing with very few players and 150 ping, because the only server in Korea that support replays is no more. I remember back where I started streaming, I was in Korea, you know, for a year. I streamed for about a half a year there before I returned to Norway, and the servers in Korea suck in Team Fortress 2. So anyone who watches from Korea, it's hats off to you. Slap on the forehead from the medic there. And we're gonna enjoy a good 5v5 on Dust Bowl. It's gonna go out and it's gonna go and attack. So how does this work if you play against less than that of a sixes team competitively? So shoot and kill the guy, and then shoot and yeah, let this medic get killed, and then shoot the other guy, and then grab the health pack, and then use the hipster shotgun, the family business. Still haven't used this enough, but it doesn't seem to be very good. It shoots faster, but it's less damage, so it's kind of counterintuitive there. So, let's see. Oh, he's gonna go, and oh! Gonna attack the enemies one at a time as a heavy! Well, that's good news for you, because unless there's... there's not any people to really focus you. I mean, you have some soldiers, but they don't... I mean, you win. Yay, I guess. You could have used any unlock in that replay there, and the result would have been the same. It's not tied to the... tied to the Tomislav. And that's, like, the thing with this weapon is that if you're not going to use it as a Tomislav, then you shouldn't be using the Tomislav. You might as well be using the minigun, or healing heater, or something else. So this is going to be panic attack once again on upward. We're going to go back here and just see what's up here. And oh, hello! Is this the work in progress high skin? Is that what we're seeing here? Well, yeah, it looks really nice. It's currently a work in progress. It's not finished yet, but working on it. So he's going to be using the Tomislav and just kind of hang out. And oh, what's this? The enemy team is busy doing this, they most likely will not see you do that. And so this is actually a good spot, as long as this. Do you think this guy sees him? Okay, let's see. Let's go to that heavy's point of view. Let's see. There he is. I think. You know, maybe. Maybe. Gates open. Oh, it's like, alright, let's go. Alright. Does this heavy, do they know? First they have the distraction soldier. He's just kind of hanging out. He's still spun up, you know, he can't hear it because it's silent. And the heavy actually dies to that soldier there. Still, you know, you can see through here. Through the chicken fence, chicken wire. Let's see, okay, here they come. Ah! Got the pyro, and no one's really paid attention to him except the medic. There's that Natasha heavy. Who saw him earlier. Does he have a memory? Nope, still behind here. Oh, surprise! Oh, the sneak attack, the secret sneaker attack. Is just mowing through them, just shooting, and they don't know how to turn around. And that's a very good utilization of the Tomislav there. And did he... No, he's still alive. Did not die, that was the other guy. So that's actually a pretty good, like, when you can do that stuff. This weapon definitely shines when the opponents are coming at you and not when you are chasing them. It's kind of hard to ambush someone and try to catch up with them when you're the slowest class in the game. So I'd suggest if you use this on, like, 5 CP or attack defend, use this on, like, use the ambush technique, kind of like on defense when the enemy teams has run past you. Or on 5 CP when you like your team has lost maybe middle or like second point and you're retreating to the retreating backwards, you kind of stay and just wait for them to come at you and then them to like one or two dudes to pass you, and then you start shooting unless they see you. That's like the that's how you get the best results using this weapon for ambush. It's basically ambush. So the problem with shooting the first guy is that people behind him is gonna see him gonna die, right? There's gonna be people who see that, and then everybody's gonna know where you are. But if you wait, there's a chance they might necessarily know where you're shooting from. Because why didn't you shoot the first guy? You know, it doesn't make any sense to them right away. So that's something you can do. And this is the gay agenda, which is all about equal rights and a flag with a bunch of colors. So he is using the lupus bar, which, you know, could work. You know, you get some additional health. Dropping the medic, you drop a deuce in toilet after taco night, then he's gonna be moving up here. Oh, and having another, because this thing recharges really quickly. So there you go. And oh, another medic. How about some bullets in your face? Oh, a pyro. How about I hard count? How about you run away? How about that? And me getting some more heals with the medic. Yes, nice lemon Royce. Oh, there's a sentry, but thanks to the recent sentry deal, if you just shoot at it long enough, it will go down. Even if it's wrangled or not, because wrangled, actually, it just gives it additional health. So there's no reason to just keep shooting at it, because if the engineer decides to repair it while it's wrangled, he's actually wasting metal. So that's good for you as a heavy, because you'll be a lot more effective. I mean, you do reduce damage, but it's about that constant damage. So just keep shooting, hold down that M1, and maybe check your back once in a while. We haven't seen anyone get stabbed, have we? No? No, not really. Does the enemy team have a spy? No. Another reason to not check your back. There's no reason to check your back for nothing that's not there. And soldiers like, I have a gold rock launcher. Fuck everybody. Like, okay, you jump away and I'll cap the cart. Oh, going with the medic. Oh, a sentry. Get the sentry and... Oh, there's a soldier again. How about you go fuck yourself? How about that? Yeah. Take him out, moving up. Oh, sniper, and that's a spy. That might have been a Dead Dream for all we know. Is he gonna check his back? Yes. Oh, he did. He saw a scout. Excellent. All right. Oh, and there's a bunch of dudes. Oh, and we're dead. Because even though we shoot, we're more accurate. We still, it's like a higher demand for your aim, I guess. You can't miss as much. So, another question that I get asked, like, a lot, like, all the time, in fact. How do you deal with spawn camp as a heavy with the Tomislav? We have a bunch of assholes that plays red, either soldier or demo man, on Dust Bowl. How do you deal? Now, this is Johnny Casey from before. They have gone forward here, so... You know, at any point in time, he could just walk out that door and shoot the guy. You know, whenever he wanted, he just could. Just whenever he felt like it, he could. And now there's two of them because he waited too long. And he could, he see them retreat and still not. Okay, now there's a demo there. You waited too long. And now they're typing on forums that Demo Man's OP, even though the map is absolutely buttshitly designed. In the fact that you have one gate you can exit through, so if you have two opposing demo men that know what they're doing, you can basically do that. And I like how the medic tried to push the other soldier out, like he tried to do that. And oh, double spy Deadringer! This might work, except not really, because they're gonna see them. And so, what do you do? Well, you don't attack it one at a time. Maybe engineer with short circuit could help, and maybe not having a guy AFK would help too. But you blame the guy that's not there, you know? He wasn't there, that's him. Okay, because sniper... Oh! The sniper actually got a kill. That guy is a badass. So, you know, at any point in time, we can just attack and run out and die, and then repeat the process with the next wave. And then you have the other demo man here. This guy who's like, fuck everything! I'm just gonna charge right out, and that's exactly what you're gonna do. And here they come with an Uber, and there's a sentry, and the engineer's like, gotta retreat! Gotta retreat with my building! But this heavy's like, fuck you! I hate your shit! And he's gonna come and shoot, and a lot of the red ones die. There's a medic there, and he tried to Uber saw him, but aim superior combined with random crits. And there's the sentry! And there's another one there. But at least we're not getting spawn camped anymore because we just attacked. Right then. The next one is actually has a good title. It's called It's Good at Long Range, but Sniper's Better. So, this is gonna be none other than some dog hairs. And he is gonna be, doing this. Together with the other guy who's gonna be doing that together. I know that they're dancing, but, replays, you know, doesn't always want you to dance. To beardy heavies. We probably sped this up. Alright, gates are open. Alright, remove the stickies. Oh shit, Kritzkrieg! The Shitzkrieg, what do we do? Oh right, Uber. Problem solved.
Easy operation.
That is easy. That's alright, time to snipe. Oh, but there was something behind him. Oh, here it is. Yeah, get that. Alright, time to snipe. Snipe back out with some random crits. Oh, there's a sniper. Well, I can snipe too. Ha 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 ha. Check it out, I'm jumping and pressing crouch. How will you ever deal with my slow ass and fat head? Mr. Sniper, can you deal? If you can deal, that's nice. So, let's look at Turbine. How does this play on a capture the flag map? Well, you would think it's pretty cool, but here we have Carmen's camera. He's gonna be playing heavy here. This is the loadout. He is... I don't fucking know, like a lumberjack reporter from the future that's a gangster. That's what he is, using the Dalukus bar. Ah, nice. So, once again, we're gonna be seeing the infamous enemy team attacks a single heavy one at a time. So yeah, he is just, oh, now they capped and then you get random crits because that's fair. And random crits, killing everything. My favorite shape is in a straight line. Shooting. Oh, dead. Right, okay. Could have done just as well with the regular minigun there. Not too much of a difference. So let's move on. Let's go back to Upward again and see what we can do there. Yes. upward. So this is going to be a recap, and we're back on camera's camera. He is still... Now he's something different. He is now... Groucho Marx, that's... What? Wait. Are those pokey things? Oh yeah, there's Pokemon. So he's a Groucho Marx reporter that's a Pokemon. Pokemon Manster. Pokemaster. That's what he is. I'm getting all the Pokemons, in fact. So, we're just having, shooting our dinghy here. Dingy, dingy, dingy. There we go. You get the idea. I'm just gonna keep it there. I'm just gonna keep the dinghy. So yeah, he's shooting a lot, you know? Not really being ambushy. So yeah, I can definitely do it with an Uber, where it's great too. If you're attacking like this, regular minigun would be better. But you never really know that, so he's actually out of ammo. He's like, punching, punching, how do I run out of ammo? Well, oh, medic's dead. Well then, it's a scout. Well, how about you go die? Yes, I'm gonna pick up your ammo. And there you go. So what you just listened to earlier was the speed dinghy. You know, it's the speedboat version. Hey, we won! Victory is our tradition here. In Fort Kick-Ass, kick your ass. Fort ass kick your ass. All right, cool. So that was all the user submitted ones. Thank you to everybody who submitted. Now we're gonna look at my replays. All right, so starting off, I'm gonna be playing on steel. So this is a map that's kind of complex and difficult to understand if you have a bad sense. But yeah, this is a little trick you can do. I like to do this. You just swap the ammo pack for your own health. It gives you more points. And sometimes you can swap lower health packs for larger health packs. Because you can do that as a heavy, and it's good for you. So once again, just doing some shots here, letting everybody know. And, oh, what's that? Is that the? Oh. Okay, thanks, Dingy. That was a good explanation, good example there. So we're just kind of hanging out, grabbing the ammo, defending here, eating the sandwich with the paper on. It's I heard it's extra protein in paper, bruh. That's why a lot of nerds are getting buff these days, because they read the books and then they eat them. So once again, you can see this is very silent, works really well, and we run into another heavy that's already spun up, and we are fairly certain that he has aiming capabilities, and there's shit going down, and we just try to shoot, and we don't get the kill, and there's the heavy, and we're like, medic, okay, there's medic, okay, quickly, alright, so we're just shooting with the Kritzkrieg, things are nice, things are great, I didn't really get that much with it. And then we're just gonna go and retreat, grab the health. Oh shit! Oh shit! Right, quickly! Shoot him! Medic! Medic! I'm going to give you the sandwich! Just hold no! Medic, you turn into a fucking fish. Die. Couldn't save him. I couldn't save him. He turned into a fish upon death as well as a unicycle. Life is really tough. Really, really tough. All right, so let's go back to upward here and let you see the camera, what's going on. Still me, we're just gonna go and try and be a bit more sneaky here. You can see I stand spun up for a long time, and that's because like you kind of want to force yourself to switch the styles, because if you don't stay spun up for extended periods of time and you just do like the normal play style, you might as well just be using the minigun. So like here, this is a good spot to be in, you know, if you're going solo. Like look at here, I am spun up and I'm actually going to stay spun up for quite a while here. So I'm just slowly aching my way up here and I'm just actually waiting, like wait for it, and yeah, ha-ha! I'm just waiting, biding my time, and oh, time to go back. Go back. Attention. Grab the health, grab the ammo. And oh, just fuck, alright. Careful. Just gonna have a snack. Masking it with a good putty dispenser. I bound that to F. So I always have my putties ready. Kill the demo with a lot of lights, and no one actually will know that we're here now that we're spun up, and we're guarding the objective. We have our back covered, and oh, there's a pyro. We kill him. And there's a spy with a dead ringer, but aha, thanks to the nerf, you're dead. Oh, and there's a soldier too. All right, so we're just gonna eat this here. And oh, demo, shit, come here. Yes, crits. Give me the crits. Does anyone? Oh. That's like the biggest victory, you know, when you get like a punch and you're like, please, for the love of God, be a random crit or else I am fucked. I am absolutely fucked. All right, so this is not really, you could, like, I would recommend doing this with the Brass Beast. This is a secret attack here on Frontier. See, you can do the jump thing. You don't really lose any speed. Jump, spawn. Okay. Just shooting some dudes. Doesn't really matter at this point. Go mid range, pretty good. And this is the secret attack. Did you know that you can stand on top of this and shoot? What's good about this spot? Well, you can't get headshot, but it's hard for you to get backstabbed. So if you're using the Brass Beast, you can stay here. You take more damage, and you also get health and ammo from the thing. We're like also behind this thing, so it could maybe be harder to see for sniper. We're like, ha ha ha, secret attack, and we also sometimes service glitches out, so we glitch back and forth. That's fair, the secret attack of standing on top of the cart and then getting shot. It was so secret they found out about it later, but it works. It works with any minigun, in fact. So let's take a look at a 5 CP map. Let's go to Granary, which is gonna be the representative for this episode for us. So let's see here, oh. Also, remember to Kanga or to Krasno kick, whatever the Kratz, the Power Ranger kick, the Russian Power Ranger kick to gain more speed in the beginning. So we're just gonna attack and go moving up, and okay, Heavy is dead. We're just shooting, staying spun up for extended period of time, throwing a sandwich to teammates because they need it more than us. It's about being effective, and as you can see, we're just checking all the sides. Oh, what's that? Oh! We get the buff. Right. Boom! Yeah. Oh, yes! Getting the medic. Now we have crits. Die. Alright, so if you can get the Conjurer buff with the killing those with boxing, it's gonna be pretty good if you can get a kill with it, because you will maintain speed and then get crits, and you can keep running, you can kind of chain it. So it's super good for that. It's one of the hidden strategies. And then you just gotta just finish up the job here. So, I mean, you all saw that from third view, so let's look at it in the first person view, just exactly what it looked like. I just have to fast forward backwards, backwards a little bit. So let's see, yeah, here we go. And voila. So we see we have the speed and we get the soldier. He was weak and it wasn't a crit anyway, so it worked. And then we just get a bunch of crits here and we just mow everything down. If the other team didn't have Uber, they would have been so fucked, but it doesn't really matter. We just brrrr our way in here. Oh, die, we've seen this. Oh, but look at this. Fast is better, said Sonic. Oh, stabbed. Hey, a wheel. Sweet. So it works pretty well with the killing gloves of boxing, so let's look at more killing gloves of boxing, because that's like my favorite thing to use. I remember I used it when gloves running urgently were new, so I was like, like running faster, fuck that, I want to punch people in the face with my boxing glove and then use crits. First I'll bait them into, like, you know, kind of like a one-on-one duel, but then I'll shoot them and just punch them anyway because I'm a fucking asshole that way. So let's see, this is a mountain lab, by the way. And we're moving up, throwing sandwich to our heavy friend. And we're just gonna go. All right, just standing on the point, staying revved up. Might not use this now, but it's doesn't really matter. Just trying to cap. Other heavies getting swarmed. There's a scout there. Oh, we got Uber. Okay, we got the gloves out. The gloves are out. Oh, we got the kill. Oh, get the crits. Get the get the medic. Oh, can you stop this? This is too good for you. Uber boxing gloves? You don't stand a chance. Yeah, I'm gonna throw the sandwich to the medic. We got it. Time to finish up. Yeah. Alright, so we're just gonna go up top. Like, it makes a slight sound when you spin up, but like most people won't even register that. So there you go, and just staying at the high ground, jumping down. And we're dead. Cool, sweet. Let's see, was that? No. That was not the last one. The next one is the last one. So what is more silent than a spun up Tomislav, ladies and gentlemen? What is? Can I spice speed up this way? No. So we're just finishing up here. So hopefully you've learned something here. And I see people are having a field day in the chat on here on stream. So that's pretty good. So we're just moving up here, just waiting for the gates to open. And now we're doing another dance. All right, we're getting into position. All right. Okay, you can't get up there. Let's just turn up the audio. Right. We actually heard the decloak sound, the medic said spy, and we didn't turn around because we're stupid and slow reaction time. Yes, but that was the Tomislav. Hopefully you gained some kind of idea, like I think you have already, but it's kind of easy to overuse the Tomislav and not really use the minigun when you're supposed to use the minigun, because you do want to have, I do want you to have the knowledge to know when to switch between both. And if you're going to use the Tomislav, try to stay more revved up than you normally would. That would really help with the weapon and helps you ambush and stuff like that. From what I've seen, or what we've seen here, a lot of people use the Tomislav exactly like they use the minigun. And if you do that, if you don't make a conscious choice to do something different, you might as well just be using the minigun and reap the benefits which that rolls. So with that, we're going to end it here. I'm going to let you know what the topic is going to be for the next episode that we're going to do. And I'm really looking forward to this one. It's going to be the detonator. Oh, yes, the detonator for the pyro. Let's see, do I even have it? I hope I do, because I should be having a... Yes, there we go. There it is, the detonator. And you alt jump, and you can jump, you can rocket jump, so you can do that. Definitely, definitely looking forward to that episode. There's some really talented players that was like, hey, are you doing an episode? And I'm like, yeah, I'm doing an episode. And they're like, we want to submit stuff or show you stuff. And I'm like, cool. So we're going to look at a lot of cool jumps, maybe take a little different take on it. But definitely, Detonator is super fun. Super, super fun. And thank you guys for watching. And I will see you next time and streaming on YouTube from now on. So be sure to check that out. Thank you and good night.